Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup, you yourself who secure my portion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins and to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your word made flesh in splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made the bishop St. Norbert a servant of your church, outstanding in his prayer and pastoral zeal, grant we ask that by the help of his intercession, the flock of the faithful may always find shepherds after your own heart and be fed in the pastures of salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage, through all patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but following their own desire and insatiable curiosity, will accumulate teachers and will stop listening to the truth and will be diverted to myths. But you be self-possessed in all circumstances. Put up with hardship, perform the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
My mouth shall be filled with your praise, with your glory day by day. Cast me not off in my old age, as my strength fails. Forsake me not.
I will sing of your salvation.
But I will always hope and praise you ever more and more. My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will treat of the mighty works of the Lord. O God, I will tell of your singular justice. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing of your salvation.
So I will give you thanks with music on the lyre, for your faithfulness, O my God. I will sing your praises with the harp, O Holy One of Israel.
I will sing of your salvation.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia.
In the course of his teaching, Jesus said, "Beware of the scribes, who like to go around and mock roads and accept greetings in the marketplace, seats of honor in synagogues, and places of honor at banquets. They devour the houses of widows, and as a pretext, recite lengthy prayers. They will receive a very severe condemnation." He sat down opposite the treasury and observed how the crowd put money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. A poor widow also came and put in 2 small coins, worth a few cents. Calling his disciples to himself, he said to them, "Amen, I say to you, this poor widow put in more than all the other contributors to the treasury. For they have all contributed from their surplus wealth, but she from her poverty has contributed all she has, her whole livelihood." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
To Today in our readings we hear about St. Paul, who's speaking to Timothy, who is himself a young bishop. And then we hear about Jesus' condemnation of the scribes and Pharisees. And both of those represent the teachers of the people. And so Paul encourages Timothy to be steadfast in his faith, to continue to preach and to teach the gospel when it's difficult or when it's easy. Do so with patience. Because he recognizes that there will come a time when the people who are listening will no longer be very attentive. They'll be seeking out other myths. And so they'll be following their own stories, things that they like that sound better, because the gospel is no longer interesting enough, no longer compelling or worth their time. So Paul encourages Timothy to be steadfast in and to keep preaching that gospel and continue to live out his faith. And Jesus shows that danger that can come for those whose job it is to preach or to teach when they start falling into all the trappings of it. The greetings at the marketplaces, the distinction that comes from, you know, being in that lifestyle and then being put in high places at dinners and all that stuff. And Jesus calls the disciples to look at what's more important. Not the external observances and the external signs, but rather at the heart of it. And so he points to the woman who gives the 2 coins she has from her poverty, showing that the heart that's converted to the Lord, that's willing to give all that it has for the Lord's sake and for his glory, that's the heart that's pleasing to the Lord. Not the one that merely lives the external. And St. Paul then, in kind of a second way, calls us to mind of asking ourselves this question. Are we ourselves convinced by the gospel, or are we looking for other avenues? Are we more convinced by the newest teaching, the newest self-help book, whatever the popular trend and distortion of the gospel is? Or are we seeking the Lord to be obedient to the teaching of the church, to seek what the true wisdom is that's found there, even if it's given by someone who we don't particularly like? Oftentimes we hear about, like, oh, this bishop said this, they're not doing a good enough job, or Pope said this, I don't know what he's saying. But are we using that as an excuse then to cast off the teaching of the church and look for our own answers? Are we seeking to go deeper, to open our hearts to the Lord as he teaches us through his church, to go deeper to seek the wisdom which we may not see right up front, but to go deeper and to learn and to recognize it, so we can be fed by that true food which you find in the gospel, which is preached by the church? And today the church celebrates St. Norbert. And St. Norbert is an interesting saint because he was a rich man, similar to like a trust fund baby whose mother was related to the emperor, and this is in the medieval times, so he's able to go and join the court of the emperor and live just a life of luxury. And they say that one time when he's out on his horse, he falls off and lays there for an hour, half dead. He asks himself the question, Lord, what should I do? And he hears the voice of the Lord say to him, stop doing evil, start doing good. Seek peace and strive after it. And so that's what he begins to do. He was pursuing holy orders until he becomes himself a priest and then seeks permission to start preaching the gospel. It goes about like a mendicant. But then he's then commissioned by a bishop to help reform some of his canons. So those were similar to a religious order, but there's a community of priests gathered around the bishop whose job it was to oppress. And so he ends up performing that canon and eventually forms his own community in a similar format, which is now called the Norbertines. And you can still, they're still around today, and they're even experiencing a bit of a growth recently. They have a monastery out in California, and they're getting new numbers coming in. They're building a new facility. because their focus is good. Their contemplative order focused on the Eucharist, on prayer, and on teaching. And so we see how when someone, like St. Norbert, when he gives himself completely over to the Lord, similar to that woman who gives the 2 coins all that she has, St. Norbert gave all that he has, followed the Lord's plan. It took different turns, but he was able to do a great work in the church that continues to bear fruit to this day. And so for each of us, we can ask St. Norbert for that guidance, one for an increased devotion in the Eucharist, which he was known for, and that order is known for, but also for increased docility to the teaching of the church, to be led by her, to be guided by her, so you can grow to be better disciples, better sons and daughters. Confident in our most merciful Lord, let us bring our prayers before him, that the church may receive the favor of the Lord and protection against the idols and false gods of our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all nations may prosper under the beneficent hand of God and be pleased to be blessed with peaceful resolution of conflict. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are poor, sick, imprisoned, or lonely may be delivered from their burdens through the healing wounds of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may bless all the men and women from our community serving in the armed forces and return them safely to their families. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a swift end to the coronavirus pandemic, that God the Father would heal the sick, strengthen those who care for them, give wisdom to those developing a cure, and help us to persevere in faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all our faithful departed may soon sit at the bench. And for Carl Froschel and for, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever loving and gracious Father, we humbly offer these petitions to you today through your Son, Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth that has been enhanced, to become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine that has been enhanced, to become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Most merciful, pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of your name, for our good and of all that holy church.
Most merciful God, we're pleased to create in blessed Norbert the new man in your image, the old having passed away. Graciously grant, we pray, that renewed like him, we may offer you the acceptable sacrifice of conciliation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Norbert, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayer. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples and take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for men for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
By divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, you may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant us peace and unity, in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always,
and with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us."
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The Lord is my portion. He is good to the soul that seeks him. spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. By the power of this sacrament, Lord, we pray, lead us always in your love through the example of Blessed Norbert, and bring to fulfillment the good work you've begun in us until the day of Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.